Hey everybody, it's 40. Welcome back to XCOM Chimera Squad, and we're interrupted by Floyd Tesseract.
I was an architect of the invasion, as much as a slave to the elders can build anything. But I broke your world. You didn't know how to fight back, to think for yourselves. Well, you better start, or someone else will do it for you. And who will you blame this time, I'm Floyd Tesseract, and I'm here to show you why you should have believed.
Interesting stuff. Anyway, so last time we did a progeny mission where we had to take care of a recruiter and somehow did that without losing anybody, despite me being woefully underprepared, not having terminal, and not having enough medkits to really go anywhere with. We did have the scavenger market that's open today, and I did already grab the frag grenade, which will be useful. I think it more immediately than the other stuff. So Eternal back in the fold. It's now time for Blue Blood to go get that scar healed, which I still proclaim was kind of BS. Lucky, a lot of lucky shots. Now, once again, we can investigate Prodigy Presence, move that counter down by 2 days, put it down to 3 days, or we go to tech support, get a meta patch, a breach item that functions kind of like Terminal's refresh. Or we could do Lost and Found, get 55 credits, and knock the unrest down by 2 here, while more importantly preventing it from going over the top. We don't want that, obviously. We do have quarantine in play, so what I'm going to do is use it. I'm going to freeze the tech support district, so the fringe will now be stuck at 1. I'm also going to use the vigilance, because why wouldn't I? I'm going to cut this down by 2. And as far as the other abilities, I don't have them yet, because I need more field teams and better field teams, respectively. So, to Lost and Found. Unknown hostiles are right on the scene, and there's an abandoned tech cache, apparently. So it's a smash and grab, whereas if you're looking at tech support, it looks like also smash and grab.
If a hostile force will cause imminent harm, you'll need to stop them by any means necessary.
No kin.
As always,
one encounter.
Targets is preferable. We learn far more from captures than corpses.
So am I going to really change anything here? Not particularly. What I am going to do, though, is I'm going to give Claymore the frag, because if you combine that with the shrapnel bomb, you can cause chain explosions that could do a lot of damage. Hint, hint. He's a walking breach charge, so I'm not going to worry about that. I don't think I'm dealing with a wall this time either. No, I'm not. It looks like I'm going to be dealing with possibly three options here, which is kind of crazy. Yeah, kind of. I'm just going to stick with what I have right now. I think I'll be okay, provided there's no more crazy surprises. But let's go. Truthfully, for this one, I don't really need a breaching charge or an auto key card based on what I'm given. And even if I did need them, well, I have Terminal and Claymore. It's kind of weird how you need,
weapons free.
I always originally thought that the keypad door was kind of like a key card, get a combo, but no. Anyway, through the side door, we'll have 2 enemies here, and a delayed scan. Last unit through is marked, but a successful shot on an enemy during breach will stun, meaning that the enemy will be stunned during the breach and won't be able to retaliate or respond in kind. This is useful if you have somebody who's a guaranteed hit, like, say, Torque, for example. Or I can go through here. First unit through here will get an armor for the encounter. Not a bad option either. So you have options here. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the side door, because I'm going to try to exploit the stun. Once again, we're going to lead off with 2, but of course we're going to put the 4th person we're going to put the person I want going second last, so that I can use team up. Being one encounter, I'll get away with it, no problem. And I'm thinking what I'm going to do is use Terminal here. I'm going to put Cherub here. I'm going to put Claymore here. And we're going to go Ballistic. Let's go.
Move in, now.
So the two enemies here are a Hitman and a Thrall. Well, the Thrall is a guaranteed stun if I do this, and a guaranteed kill because of poison damage. So we don't have to worry about him anymore. The Hitman we can worry about, though. And didn't really get good damage there. On the other side, we have a trooper right here who's just asking to get his ass kicked. And you know, I'm just gonna turn to fire. Claymore, finish the job. Not bad. So it looks like we have a new enemy here. A brute. A mutant that works for Shrike. So obviously melee is a big thing. A big part of his game. We also have what looks like a resonant right there. We have a bruiser over there. We also have explodies. There's exploding barrels pretty close to where we are right now. Now as usual, we have options, so let's use them. This appears to be just a clearing, huh? Interesting. So no smash or grab this time, just simply smash and go. I'm gonna take this opportunity to use the bruiser right to take this flashbang to get the bruiser. And get the mutant disabled a little bit. Get a team up going. Like I said, I'm gonna slap this one on Claymore. And Torque. Well, Torque's gonna do what Torque does best: harass things. That guy's gonna die from poison, so he is kind of just a moot point. In truth, the Bruiser's not a bad option. The Hitman's also a very good option. I could get the kill off the Hitman now if I really desired it. And I'll be honest, I do. I do desire it. So let's off the Hitman right now, put a hit on this guy, bind him, and end him. Great start. A very good start right now. Now, we have a new frag grenade. Now, we're going to use this thing unique. We're going to go with the shrapnel bomb here. And I'm going to place it right here. That's one action taken. Now, we're going to throw the grenade at it. I'm going to try to get the bruiser with this. And hopefully the chain reaction. I'm banking on this now. Let's just make sure that it would hit the charge. My hunch is it would. I mean, I don't see why it wouldn't. Yeah, it looks like, unfortunately, I'm going to have to hit the brute with this in order to get the thing to blow up. Which is fine, because I'll take out the brute with this. Achievement unlocked, chain reaction, yay. I think I did a number. Oh yeah, Bloodlust. He'll move closer to you. You know, why not do this? You see that damage right there? That means the damage that will inflict on these enemies right here will be 3. I don't know what type of barrel it is, but I do know is that it would hurt like hell. So I could probably take both of them out if I try. And honestly, with that low cover and that defense, it's probably the wisest option. And it will guarantee kill the brute. It may burn the bruiser. I don't know if it will, but I'm gonna find out. It did not burn the bruiser, I don't think, but that's okay. Because he's disoriented and he is in dire straits. He just up and left. So that's an awesome feeling. And what this leaves is just the resonant, which is terrific news. Just fire away. That's not good, Terminal. That's not good. Kinetic shield on Terminal. This will negate the marked. And then I'll use this opportunity to try to off the resonant. I guess things can't be that simple, huh? Honestly, a questionable tactic when you consider I can off him without trying. See?
You, come here.
He's gone. I could try subduing him, actually, but... You know what? I am going to try subdue him. Because if she fails, Claymore won't.
Should have squeezed you unconscious.
Yeah, too bad a squeeze is a kill. Can't suffocate him into a coma. Whatever.
Target subdued.
Just a minor inconvenience at the end of the day. And here, let's finish you off the right way.
Stay down.
Not a bad way to start, a flawless. That worked out pretty well. Claymore's fireworks really did pay off. And the assembly is complete. We now have enhanced SMGs. Give us a little more damage.
Alright, let's get to it. You people hear this bonded stair crap? Whoever's behind it knows their way around Advent propaganda. They say don't talk, don't think, but let me tell you how the world is. That's your first clue. The voice on the radio is never your friend.
Okay. So, since we're low in Illyrium, we can't do any more of this enhanced or mastercrafted stuff. That's fine. Improving the field teams isn't a bad option either. But I kind of want to... If I want to spend one day, I'm going to spend one day on this. Because I mentioned some of these bombs are actually pretty good. And could be useful in a pinch. As far as the supply goes, as you see, I cannot buy an enhanced pistol or an enhanced SMG at this point. Unfortunate, but it is what it is. So now we're left with situation, just one situation actually, which is interesting. So, where's the fire, right? Oh no, I see the Lyrium Smuggler here for 60. Okay, kind of a tempting choice no matter which one I pick. Situations won't really destroy any of the panics, so that's kind of out. And since I don't have any level 2s, I can't benefit off of district missions or district situations. So which one am I going to go for? I'm going to go for the Illyrium Smuggler. Get myself 60 credits. Blue Blood is now back on the scene.
Ugh, I feel so tired, and it's not even noon.
What did you have for breakfast?
I'll tell you what she didn't have. Big Crunch.
The cereal that writhes?
That's the one.
I love this
How
one.
How does that even work?
We dip gene-tailored larval nuggets into our special batter. Simply add warm milk and prepare for a big crunch.
Big crunch!
Milk from any warm-blooded mammal will end the nugget's hibernation. Then you're ready for some big crunch.
That sounds fun, but I'm a human. Can I have some too?
Of course! Nearly everyone can eat Big Crunch.
What about me?
I said nearly. Under no circumstances should sectoids consume Big Crunch.
Aw, dang.
Well, I know what I'm having. A wriggling bowl of... Oh, go on. You can say it.
Big Crunch. The cereal that rides.
Okay, I'm a bit of a sucker for when you ham it up.
Future.
That's kind of why I like Disgaea so much, is because they really ham up the characters a lot. when they're screaming about pretty rule, like Valator screams about pretty rule number one all the time, things like that. I'm a sucker for that sort of thing. Pretty rule number one! Should always include the word dude in every line you say! Sorry, I had to get that out. I had to do that. Anyway. Didn't take long at all. I'm actually kind of fortunate. So, we have a hot tip. This will give us tracer rounds. Tracer rounds will give you 5% aim. And it looks like a smash and grab. I get 20 intel of it. Or, I get a targeting system weapon mod and 25 intel. I don't remember what the targeting system does. But it's a freaking extraction. And you know something? It actually logically is better to do this because this way I can prevent it from going into, you know, the 5 panic range. So, yes. We'll go for the tracer rounds in this case. And now we have newly minted enhanced SMGs. As you see, an enhanced SMG does a little more damage. Not a bad thing. Not a bad thing at all. So, two encounters, a wall, and a keypad door. You know what that means. That means Claymore is in the house. And we'll actually get to see what the concussive charge can really do. So, let's go. So we may not be able to get that bowl of big crunch, but we are going to get a big entrance at least, because wherever that wall is, that's where Claymore's going.
Contraband confirmed on site.
Which means we are laying the lumber, baby. It's going to be beautiful. So as you see, last unit through here has the weapon disabled, and it's more likely going to end with me getting jumped. Explosive entrance here will end all non-aggressive enemies guarding the entrance are surprised. Once again, if everybody goes through this one entrance, not a bad thing. If you go through multiple entrances, you're going to still see your share of alerts and aggressives. Well, actually, yeah, alerts. So, it's not as great as you think. But let's get it underway, Claymore. Let's prepare for the big crunch. And watch the enemies that writhe. Torque 2. You know what? No, Terminal 2. In case I need to heal. I learned my lesson from Blue Blood a little bit. Torque 3. Cherub 4. Actually, no. Cherub 3. Torque 4. Go!
Opening a side door.
Let's see if this worked. Okay, just one guy's alert. Everyone else is caught with their pants down. Just this bruiser right here, huh? 71%. A resident 76, not a bad option. And 2 at 81, including a brute. Interesting. Okay. Go for the brute. Nice hit. I have some plan for Torque. Don't worry, that trooper's not gonna live. The resident's an option. The Thrall is an option. That Bruiser is an option. Okay, you know what? The Brute's gonna go bye-bye. Addition through subtraction and all that shit. And Trooper or Thrall, that's a no-brainer. You go for the Trooper every time. Of course the Bruiser's not a bad option either. I can off the Bruiser. As you see, there's still some enemies there who are alert, despite the fact that they weren't guarding the entrance. So it's not as foolproof as you think. So we have a hostage taker here and someone who's going to try to off the hostage. The assailant right here, usually the last one. This is a sorcerer. Scary mother. A scary mother indeed. The sorcerer likes to make things miserable for you because it will teleport, it will give enemies immediate actions, it can negate certain things, it can melee you and heal itself. It has a host of things you won't like. Remember, we have two things we gotta worry about here. So, let's start with a shrapnel bomb. And it's going to get the Thrall and the Trooper in range, and I do see explosives there. What looks like explosive drums.
Need me to get a clear shot?
And since we haven't moved this turn, looks like it might not get the Thrall. Oh well. I thought the game was going to give it to me. I guess not. Okay.
Her words fall like tears.
It looks like the game just let the sorcerer go and get a turn off for whatever reason. Subservience. If I shoot the sorcerer is going to reflect the damage to the victim. It'll almost certainly kill it. But you know, not pretty. Okay. A pin down on the resonant is probably what the doctor ordered, more than anything else. But the trooper is obviously in no cover, so it should be an easy knockout.
That's it. You're done.
Cherub's up next, and I'm thinking of slapping Torque with it.
Now that's protection.
I still hate that one-liner. So you know what? We are gonna go. It looks like I can't go for the sorcerer. Oh well. I'm gonna go for the resonant then, if that's the case. It's only 58%, so I don't care. Now, I'm gonna try something a little different here. I'm actually gonna try to tongue the sorcerer despite the subservience and plan, and see what happens. I don't know what will happen, to be honest.
Watch me move.
The hostage taker will be the only one who goes after the civilian. Everyone else will ignore them and go for you. 81%, huh? Interesting. And if I shot at it? 50%, wow. Even though I'm flanking it, go fig. Well, attacking the sorcerer will kill the thrall if it sticks. And that's what I'm going to go for then. So we just destroyed the thrall. 10 damage. Unfortunately, it looks like our little friend here is going to be knocked out. This is a bonus objective, so it's not the end of the world. And it looks like the civilian's still alive, huh? How about that? Okay, Claymore. What are you going to do here, Claymore? I'm going to have you shift over here. And I'm going to have you prepare a little greeting for somebody, namely the sorcerer. Yeah, you don't have to worry about misfires hitting the civilian. If only it worked like this in real life. Side domain from the resonant to end the turn. That's not exactly what I had in mind. I don't think it was tactically a very smart move on their part. Because as you see, the hostage taker is down, and now the hostage is free. Beautiful. Beautiful. Alright, shield on Claymore. We have this on cruise control right now. Might as well fire again. So only a measly 2 damage there. I'm actually pretty pleased with it. Torque can finish the job. And now we have a keypad door. Overseer, the last unit automatically activates Overwatch during the breach. Okay. So now, what we're going to do is we're going to... put Claymore third. I'm going to keep Cherub 4. I think I'm going to have him use the Overwatch. Also, you have the option to abort a mission after an encounter if things are going really bad. We're not doing that. 3 enemies guarding the entrance. We should be okay unless they all want to attack us at once. 2 of them do. Including an acolyte. Okay. That's fine. Poison the trooper, it kills it when its turn comes. The Acolyte I'm a little scared of. But you know, taking the Thrall out is better. Because at least it's a score. Try the shotgun. To no results. And we'll phalanx here, that way we get our two charges. Might as well, it's the last encounter.
Target spotted. Once you have it, leave.
Okay. One thing I didn't mention about these situations, these smash and grabs, is that if you kill enough enemies, that will trigger reinforcements as well as you just acquiring the thing in question. So it's kind of important you have to be on the lookout for that too. Take these things into account. We're gonna actually go and get all three of these guys. Merry Christmas, you filthy animal.
I like the flash. Could do without the bang.
Disoriented the sorcerer, it looks like. So no, it didn't. It looks like the sorcerer was fine. Sorcerer, I believe, is also considered part of Shrike. So, Claymore, you're gonna go next. I have a special plan for you. Well, you know what the special plan is, obviously, but for me, I'm gonna take the opportunity again to better cover. And I'm going to start firing at barrels, if they're available. So it looks like we can hit a brute with this one. It's not a bad option. 3 damage to the brute. It'll shred the armor. So it'll probably be 2 damage to the brute. But it'll be wide open. Other options include using a tongue pull. And honestly, doesn't look like I have much to go there. So if I look at my shooting options, we're at a 67 on the thing that's going to die. A brute at 56. An Acolyte of 55 was probably going to be the most scary proposition. I think we suck it up, and we just simply go with the explosion. Claymore. Once again, the shrapnel plus the grenade is always a good option. Now, it doesn't look like I can get up to the second floor with it, but I'll tell you what I can do. I can certainly go here. If I go here, I can take out both the Hitman and the Brute. Oh, maybe not the Hitman. Definitely the Brute, though. They're both flashing, so it looks like it would hit. So, that's one go. Frag grenade. Take this guy out. Both of them are in range, and the shrapnel bomb is also in range, so guess what we're getting out of this deal? 2 kills. Okay, nearly 2 kills. We'll say 1 in, like, 1.9. And I guess a risk-free shot.
Drop to hostile.
Well then! Great job, Claymore. Great job. Let's see, who could use some healing? Looks like Torque needs a little bit. I don't know if the Hitman's gonna shoot or run, to be honest. I'm a little more worried about the guy up there, the Bruiser, but I think I'll be okay. You know, I think I'm just gonna go Overwatch here. If he moves, I'll have a better chance to stick him.
Nice coverage.
Of course he didn't.
Nice strike, jackass.
But it's nice to see that they know how to miss. So you know how my luck has been. Also, great job. Cherub, there are times where I really question why the hell I bring you along. And there are times I go, this is why I brought you
There's
along.
There's no need for this.
Okay. A charge bash does sound like a very nice option. It would knock out the Hitman, and it would do damage to the Sorcerer. Two things I can definitely get along with. It's a dash, it's risky, it'll put me in wide open position, most likely, but, you know, can't pass up the points of damage, in this case. 5 damage. And also, don't forget he's got guard. The sorcerer can teleport, like I said. And seems to be teleporting into a position where it's... Oh boy. Tyranny. Bruiser gets to go immediately. Alright. So, not bad. Not bad, actually. I don't know where the exit's gonna be, and I'm gonna say it's right where I came in, but... You never know. Either way. What we do have is we have an opportunity to go and take both these guys out before things get really ugly. And we're gonna take out the sorcerer because she is just way worse. Way worse than the bruiser. Sorcerer's one of the worst enemies, in my opinion. And with that in mind, I'm gonna bring Claymore up to... No, I'm not going to bring Claymore up top. I'm just going to simply bring him closer. Actually, no, I'm going to leave him there. And watch as your 91 spectacularly flies over his head. Like an idiot. Can't make this shit up. But yeah, I guess you can pin him down. So that is something. Push him down a little bit. Since I didn't see that 91 miss coming. But hey, it happens. It is 1 in 10 after all. And take this opportunity to acquire what I need, and hopefully next turn, try to pull Cherub out of the fire. So where's the exit? Right where I came in, pretty much. That's actually pretty good. I can get myself out of this predicament pretty easily, I think. That looks like a trooper, that looks like a bruiser. And that looks like a trooper as well. Not bad. So let's pull Cherub out of there right now.
You took a bath today.
Thanks, Torque.
And let's pull Torque into... Do I want to pull Torque into cover, or do I want to... Yeah, I'm gonna pull Torque into cover.
Covering ground. Get a move on.
I am low on ammunition.
As far as Claymore goes, he's in great cover, and this bruiser really is the only true threat I see. We're gonna go for the kill.
Target dropped.
Good hit.
He's pretty high up in the food chain, so I'm not going to worry about... By food chain, I mean the turn system. So I feel like this isn't a bad option. Even if it means he's going to be exposed.
I can still fight.
It's Cherub who I'm worried about.
That's what matters.
And Cherub shouldn't die because he's got that...
I'm okay.
Guard. He's got that armor. Okay, terminal. Get yourself out of there. Before we leave, we take a safeguard with us, because that's a no-brainer.
On the way.
You're the best.
Now we leave. Trooper's gonna go. He's gonna probably shoot at Cherub, if I had to guess.
I'm okay for now.
Technically, I'm not really in cover now, are I? I guess technically I was. I am technically low cover.
Heading over there.
Guess it wasn't enough though. Still though, success. More reinforcements come, and that is a non-factor.
Closing on target.
Slithering.
Parting shot? Nah.
Need a fresh clip.
No, you don't. Because you're done. I'll take it. Cherub is gonna be kind of iffy on whether he develops a scar or not. I don't think he will, but sometimes it happens. Torque won't. Lightly wounded never seems to build any scars. Guard tracer rounds, don't really care about that. The hostages rescue gave us 65 credits, though, and we got 20 intel from capturing enemies. Great news. And our assembly's complete yet again. And Cherub did get a freaking scar out of that. Well, that is most unfortunate. Which one is it? Hobbled. His mobility's down by 3. Eh, not great. That's not great. But it's not the worst. We got promotions ready, though. Starting with Torque, who now gets Poison Spit. Now that toxic reading, which we used at the breach, we now can use freely. Using a Poison Spit to poison, use the Poison Cloud, get enemies poisoned. And of course, you know, if I wanted to use it on Torque, it would obviously not affect her, and I could pull enemies into the poison and do an extra 2 damage if I want. If you get enemies into a Poison Spit and they are not covered, they'll do 3 damage there, and then the poison will do 2 per. Pretty good. Pretty good item. Definitely one of her better assets. Claymore, because he did a good job. Fortitude. Okay, this is now completely uncharted territory for me with Claymore. Immune to effects of all grenades and environmental hazards. That's not bad. Or improvised explosives. Claymore regenerates a charge for carried grenades at the end of each encounter. Does that mean I basically have infinite grenades of sorts, in a sense? Hell yeah. Hell yeah. More explodey. More explodey things. Assembly was complete. We're going to move Cherub into this territory. And we're going to use this opportunity to go build up on our field teams. Because I kind of don't think I need this. I could go weapon optics too. I don't really do this one though. But I've actually never done this one. So I want to see what happens. If I go past it, will it give me the chance for enhanced weapon optics and stuff? It's only one day, so it's not going to hurt me. 2 days. Even with Cherub in the thing. That means I'm going to put Zephyr back. Blue Blood's going to be done with training very soon. I actually unlocked training now for Torque with that level up. But of course, we're not going to remove Blue Blood from this. One more day. Actually, one more day is not going to be too bad. Because normally a situation comes up, and there it is. So, the situation we are going to develop here. First, let's develop this. Now we have all but one with a field team. Bad operators get 30 Illyrium. Or investigate a strange device and get 45 intel. We're going to go with the Illyrium this time. That way I have the Illyrium set up for when I go and get our enhanced weapons done.
100 years, give or take?
Just needs a little elbow grease. And a whole lot of elbows.
Yes. Grease, because this place doesn't have enough of that.
Yeah, scavenger market opened today, but I don't have anything to go with. The frag grenade again. AP rounds is a fantastic item, sort of. I won't say fantastic, maybe too far. Advanced stock's good. AP rounds has the ability to basically negate enemies that have heavy armor. Unfortunately, there's only like 3 or 4 types of enemies that actually have anything more than 1 point of armor at a time, not counting buffs. Like, say, the Bruiser can do that to itself. And because of that, its worth kind of dwindles. There are other types of rounds that actually do more damage than AP rounds. So if you add that, so if you compare the two, usually the other rounds end up winning the day more than the AP rounds. Not saying AP rounds are useless, though, by any stretch of the imagination. There's one enemy that has a ton of armor, and it could be highly useful for that. But as for right now, we don't need it. The stock probably would have been what I would have gone for, if not the frag. So I'm going to figure out what I want to do with Blue Blood, whether I want to incorporate him right now or put him in through special ops. Also, I can check this out with Torque right now. Unlock potential. Dodge increased by 20, mobility up by 1. I think I'm going to use the opportunity to put Torque in basic conditioning. because it really should do it at some point. You really should do it at some point. Put blue blood back on the horse. So, here we are. What am I going to pick next time before the hidden faction target reveals itself? We'll find out. Anyway, I'll see you guys next time. 40 Warriors signing off.